Hey, getaway, this is Alex and let's go straight to the business. I'm gonna be sharing my experience of living 1 month and 1 day in Airbnb in Asuncion, Paraguay. If that's what you're interested in, for example, you're traveling to Asuncion for residency, obtaining purposes, which became very trendy last couple of years, or maybe you're just a traveler, or maybe you're there for some business reason, this video can be useful for you, so stay tuned. Yes, if you're planning to go there for some period of time, and it's a short period of time, first of all, I kind of recommend you to use Airbnb. It's probably the easiest way to rent an apartment there, again, especially if you're there for the short period of time. So I stayed in Asuncion for 1 month and 1 day. In the middle of the summer, the weather was great. Well, it actually was winter for Paraguay, so the weather was great. There was a couple of days when the weather was maybe around 12, 16 Celsius, but most of the time it was like 26 to 30 Celsius, which was amazing, comfortable, and you could have just, you know, walk around with your t-shirt and it would be nice. So my Airbnb was located in the area with the name Las Lomas. It was not far away from the Shopping del Sol. That's the shopping mall, one of the oldest one probably in town. And it's also not far away from another shopping, which they call Paseo Galeria. So if you planning to go to Paraguay, Asuncion, Paraguay, for a short period of time, kindly recommend you to stay in that area or around that area. They call it New Center. Now, why this place is nice, because it's in pretty safe area of the city. Well, in general, I can tell you that comparing to different countries of Latin America, and believe me, I visit maybe 70% of them. In general, Paraguay seems very tranquil, very chill, just because it's not on the radar of the most of the tourists. Probably that's that. And also comparing to other countries of this region, Latin America, they have a pretty stable, straightforward political and economy system. Do they have problems or challenges? Obviously they do. But then again, this video is not about this. This video about you and solving your problem of getting the Airbnb. By the way, I'm kindly recommending you to rent Airbnb for a short period of time. If you're staying here, staying for a longer period of time or planning to live here for some time, that's another story. I would probably recommend you to switch from Airbnb. So there's another ways of renting long-term houses, apartments, everything, you name it. So I have done my research, obviously, before coming to Asuncion. Actually, that was my second time when I visit Asuncion. The first time it was in 2023 when I visit Foz do Iguaçu in Brazil, and I just crossed the border between Foz do Iguaçu and Ciudad del Este, and then just took a bus from Ciudad del Este to Asuncion and stayed there for 2 days. By the way, I'm gonna put together the video about that experience, so stay tuned. Feel free to subscribe if you want to know about it. This time I stayed for 1 month, as I mentioned before. So why I recommend you to stay in this area or around this area? Simply because there are so many things to do here. As I mentioned, there is a shopping malls, and this area, it's in between the airport and the downtown. It's like basically in the middle. Can you live in other places? Yes, you can. But then the particular the Airbnb or this area with a couple other buildings, size skyscrapers, which are kind of Airbnb style or co-living style, they are not far away from this shopping, and you just easily can walk around. I walk around every other night in the middle of the night, and I didn't have any problems. Sometimes I was feeling that I am a threat to those wealthy people who living there. And by the way, on the way between my Airbnb and Shopping del Sol, there's a pretty fancy area with, I would say, very expensive houses, villas, whatever you want to say, because some of them, they do have those kiosks with the security, and there's not many people just passing by on the street, you know. And I was just doing my evening stroll, you know, to get a whatever, to go to the cinema in the shopping mall, or just to go to the food court and stuff. So this area is cool, so many things to do, and it's kind of in the middle of everything. Why not downtown? Well, downtown, let's say little bit rough on the edges. Some of the areas a little bit dodgy. Some areas you want to be more alert. Let's put it this way. During the day, you can go there. You know, you can walk around. Just again, stay alert. Know where you're going. Don't flash around with your cell phone and stuff. But in the night, downtown doesn't feel that nice. So for example, if you love to walk like I do, downtown, not the best place to walk in the middle of the night. As simple as that. So let's stick to this Las Lomas area. It's also not far away from Mariscal, another area with a shopping. So it was close, to be honest, to everything. I could have walked or take an Uber. By the way, I'm gonna be talking about my expenses in the next video. So Uber costs from the place where I was staying on average $3. Let's put it this way, from 1.5 to like 4.5. To go to downtown was under $5 and around 15 to 20 minutes, depends on the traffic. So once we already figure out the area, I'm gonna be showing you one particular place. This is this co-living, or if you wish, they call it Único.
That's how the neighborhood looks like in the night. That's this Único. Then you can find another building in front, and there's a supermarket, 24/7 works. Another super tall building, and it's pretty safe area. And if you're gonna go that direction, in about 10 minutes, you're gonna find yourself in the shopping del Sol.
And right now we're gonna relocate to my Airbnb. I'm gonna show it to you how it looks from the top. So here it is. There's a couple of buildings, for example, this one. By the way, right now we're gonna be next to this building. Boom. Alright, next to that building, the building Único, where I was having my Airbnb, looks like this. There's a couple of surrounding buildings, looks like these. Now back to Airbnb. On this street, there's a few more potential Airbnb you can search for. Right here on the left, or right now in the middle, there's this area you can look for some Airbnbs, maybe even there. By the way, it's kind of fancy area right there, but the only problem is a bit further from Shopping del Sol. I'm gonna be showing you direction to Shopping del Sol. That's the one. And now we're gonna relocate and have a look how Asuncion looks from the other side. Now there's other couple of potential Airbnbs, maybe there or there. That building or that building or the tall one that you can see on the left. By the way, right there behind it, there is an airport. I'm gonna maximize right now to give you an idea. So airport is just right there. You can actually see the landings and takes off. And right now I'm just gonna leave it so you can hear the sound of Asuncion and figure out how noisy it is. Around it, there are a couple of other buildings with the same concept. When they do have 24 hours reception, when they do have a gym, they do have pool, they do have like a co-working and stuff. Now I'd like to tell you a little bit more about amenities on this building. First of all, everything was located on the same floor. It was, I believe, floor number 4. There you could find gym, spa, co-working. I didn't use because I was there on vacation. However, I know it was busy because I saw people there all the time. Spa I didn't use, it's just not my thing. And gym wasn't busy at all. Sometimes it was 2-3 people, but most of the time I was there by myself. As you see, it's equipped with all the necessary, or let's put it this way, with all the basics. Because if you're a professional, then of course you need to find some gym outside. Then there was this sun deck, open area with some chill out zone. The area where you can just do some sunbathing, and of course, little pool. Pool not for swimming, more of for chilling, let's put it this way. And some nice surrounding. So that's again this complex with the name Único, or condo with the name Único, and surroundings. Also, I noticed there was one, two extinguishers next to my Airbnb and one inside of my Airbnb. So as you see, they take emergency prevention here very seriously. It's what we have in our particular building.
Right now, looking for ATM next to my apartment, so I have some cash. I'll show you how this place looks like. Okay, so it's a great success. This is the ATM. There's one actually in front of my place where I live, but it's only for the locals. This one is an international one.
Now I want to do the room tour in the Airbnb. Sorry for the stabilization. I was trying to figure out how my newly bought stabilizer works, and it looks like I didn't figure out, or just in this application I didn't put the stabilization, so the picture is a little bit weird. But again, I hope the information that I'm providing will pay off.
All right, let's have a quick tour. So that was the door. Behind the door I could hear some movement, especially when my neighbors would go to the elevator or speak loudly, but it didn't bother me that much. So this is, as you see, a studio, around 30 square meters. However, obviously I didn't check, it just feels like it has all the amenities needed, everything according to description, and everything for a long term stay. This is my king size bed, obviously. As you see, everything is raw, so I didn't, you know, make it up specially for the video. I'm just showing you how everything looks like. This is the view from the balcony on one side, and there's another side right here. A lot of movement around, you could hear it, but if you want to close the door and then shut the curtains, then, you know, you can be in pretty quiet place. This is a shower / toilet or the bathroom. Well, after 1 month it doesn't look that clean, but it's okay. As you see, once again, I didn't clean up especially for video. I'm just showing you how it looks like when a single man lives here. This is my wardrobe, and behind this door you're gonna see my luggage stored, and yes, the TV, the couch. And this is probably the most beneficial part of this apartment. It's this view. Every morning I could, you know, record, and it's incredible content together with amazing sunsets. Yeah, this is my apartment.
All right, that was my video experience of living 1 month and 1 day in the capital of Paraguay, Asuncion. Now, how much that particular Airbnb cost? It was $840. In this price range, you can find a lot of good apartments. Again, I consider that was really nice price for that 30 square meters apartment with a great view, as you probably already figure out, and so many amenities that this complex or co-living includes. You tell me, what do you think about this Airbnb? Next time I'll be back, I'll definitely gonna stay in that area, since I already know the building. I'm maybe even trying to get to the same particular Airbnb if it's gonna be available right there. If you're planning to go to Asuncion, now you have a basically straightforward scenario or straightforward directions. By the way, if you want to know how to navigate in Asuncion, you want to check out my previous video about arrival to the airport of Asuncion and using Uber. Also check out my video where I was explaining my impressions, where I was giving different advices based on my own experience. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button.